Hey YouTube, I'm Mr. Terry, a high school history teacher. Welcome back to another History Teacher Reacts video. All right, you guys, today I'm checking out a video that I was kind of inspired to check out due to the success of the last video I did, which was that popular song, Don't Stay in School. And the response to that was huge. And to kind of stay along that line, I was recommended another video kind of about education or maybe the problems with education. And this is called Suli Breaks Why I Hate School But Love Education. Okay, so all I know is just what that title says, Why I Hate School But Love Education. I don't know anything else other than that, but I am definitely down to check this out. And just like with the Don't Stay in School video, I'll tell you what I think as a teacher. And be sure to stay till the end of the video because I will unpack the whole thing and I'll tell you what I think about this. The original video link is down below. Make sure that you give it a view, like, subscribe. It's a little bit older of a video from 2012. It has nearly 9.5 million views, so I can tell this is a big deal. But you also see some other links down in the description. Just created a Twitter and Instagram account to post fun history stuff, so check that out as long as my other stuff as well. All right, let's go ahead and check this out then. All right, let's do this. Waltham Forest College. Okay.
So you want to get a degree.
Okay.
Why?
Get a job,
let me tell you
whatever.
What society will tell you. It increases your chances of getting a job, provides you with an opportunity to be successful. Your life will be a lot less stressful. Education is the key.
Oh, we kind of
now let me tell
here.
You what your parents will tell you. Make me proud. Increases your chances of getting a job, provides you with an opportunity to be successful. Your life will be a lot less stressful. Education is the key.
Okay.
Now let's look at the statistics. Steve Jobs, net worth, $7 billion. R.I.P.
Oh no, are we gonna do the anecdotes? Okay, these people though may not have had this formal education, but were successful using these anecdotes as evidence or proof that what education is or school isn't necessary. We'll see where he's taking this though.
Richard Branson, net worth $4.2 billion. Oprah Winfrey, net worth $2.7 billion. Mark Zuckerberg, Henry Ford, Steven Spielberg, Bill Gates. Now here comes the coup de grace.
None of them, yeah, degrees.
Looking at these individuals, what's your conclusion? Neither of them, in being successful, ever graduated from a higher learning institution. Now some of you will protest.
Most of them did go to them, though. I mean, Bill Gates went to Harvard. I mean, he's at that level, right, of education. And then saw what he wants to do doesn't require that. And then, you know, the company takes off and everything like that. So, yeah, those people were a lot of geniuses without having school to do that. But what if you're not on that level of those people? Right? Can education give you those opportunities and expose you to new things?
Like, you know, money's only the medium by which one measures worldly success. And some of you
just
even have the nerve to say, I don't do it for the money. So what are you studying?
Happiness is the measure to success. Yes, money can help with happiness in a way because you may be able to reduce some things that may cause you stress. Doesn't cause you pure happiness itself. But now happiness is whatever that means to you.
To work for a charity. Need more clarity? Let's look at the statistics. Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon him, Socrates, Malcolm X, Mother Teresa, Spielberg, Shakespeare, Beethoven, Jesse Owens, Muhammad Ali, Sean Carter, Michael Jeffrey Jordan, Michael Joseph Jackson, were either of these people unsuccessful or uneducated? All I'm saying is that
weren't.
If there was a family tree, hard work and education would be related, but school would probably be a distant cousin. Because if education is the key, then school is the lock. Because it rarely ever develops your mind to the point where it can perceive red as green and continue to go when someone else says stop. Because as long as you follow the rules and pass the exams, you're cool. But are you aware that examiners have a checklist? And if your answer is something outside of the box, the automatic response is a cross. And then they claim that school expands your horizons and your visions. Well, tell that to Malcolm X, who dropped out of school and is well renowned for what he learned in a prison. Proverbs
or anecdotes.
17:16. It does a fool no good to spend money on an education. Why? Because he has no common sense. George Bush. Need I say more? Education is about inspiring one's mind, not just filling their head. And take this from me, because I'm an educated man myself, who only came to this realization after countless nights in the library, with a can of Red Bull keeping me awake till dawn and another can in the morn.
Been there.
Falling asleep in between piles of books, which probably equated to the same amount I had spent on my rent. Memorize equation, facts and dates right down to the letter, half of which I'd never remember and half of which I'd forget straight after the exam and before the start of the next
That's
semester.
True. That's always been a thing, right? You forget afterwards, especially if it's not applicable, but it did show your, at least your knowledge at a time, right?
Asking anyone if they had notes for the last lecture. I often found myself running to class just so I could find a spot on which I could rest my head and fall asleep without making a scene. Ironic. Because that's the only time I ever spent in university, chasing my dreams. And then after nights with a dead mind, I then find myself in a queue of half-awake student zombies waiting to hand in an assignment. Maybe that's why they called it a deadline. And then after 3 years of mental suppression and frustration, my proud mother didn't even turn up to my graduation.
That's sad.
Now, I'm not saying that school is evil and there's nothing to
do. Okay, so good. So he's broken things down. He's broken things, problems that he has. I'm hoping to hear now solutions, advice, things like that. Because he threw out all the outliers in history, right? Yeah, Michael Jordan did graduate from high school. He got his education in school, though. He did get his education, his basketball education, right? In the confines of North Carolina, right? With a great teacher, Dean Smith, and went on to do that. All those billionaires you talked about too, right? Received education of some kind. These people are such outliers. Their work ethic, their intellect is so insanely off the chart that it breaks anything that formal education can give you. So if we say, what about the rest of us? What is the solution for the rest of us?
Game. But all I'm saying is understand your motives and reassess your aims, because if you want a job working for someone else, then help yourself. But then that would be a contradiction, because you wouldn't really be helping yourself, you'd be helping somebody else. There's a saying which says, if you don't build your dream, someone else will hire you to help build theirs.
A little anti-capitalism there.
Education. Understand its true meaning. Education is not just about regurgitating facts from a book on someone else's opinion on a subject to pass an exam.
True.
Look at it. Picasso was educated in creating art. Sure. Shakespeare was educated in the art of all that was written. Colonel Harlan Sanders was educated in the art of creating Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Mm.
I once saw David Beckham take a free kick. I watched as the side of his Adidas-sponsored boot hit the patent leather of the ball at an angle which caused it to travel towards the skies as though it was destined for the heavens. And then as it reached the peak of its momentum, as though it changed its mind, it switched directions. I watched as the goalkeeper froze, as though reciting to himself the laws of physics, and as though his brain was negotiating with his eyes that it was indeed
true,
witnessing the spectacle of the leather swan that was swooping towards it, and then reacting. But only a fraction of a millisecond too late. And before the net of the goal embraced the FIFA-sponsored ball as though it was the prodigal son returning home, and the country that I live in erupted into cheers, I looked at the play and thought, damn. Looking at David Beckham, there's more than one way in this world to be an educated man.
What is it? What is it? We want to know, right? Let me tell you what I think about this. All right, good little expose, I guess, if you will. The biggest thing I guess I would take away from this is this. You know, it is common. I hear it all the time where people bring up Bill Gates, et cetera, these other people that kind of broke the mold. And I already talked about kind of the different, how those people are different than most people, right? They are very, very different than most people. The way that they function, the way that they act. And then, so then should it be then, do you follow what it is that made those people successful? Would those people even be able to explain that, right? To articulate that to you, to us as people, what makes them successful? Or is it so simple that it seems simple to them, but may not be as simple to us? Then he also, he comes down too with the idea of where schooling will have you work for someone else. And then with the problems, I guess, with that. And I don't know if he's trying to say necessarily that that should not be our aim, to work for someone else, right? Is that kind of thing feasible? Can we all be Bill Gates, right? Do we want to be Bill Gates? Do we want to be Michael Jordan, right? Do we want to be Richard Branson? Whatever. You know, the thing I said at the beginning was the measure of success should be happiness, right? And if people look at Bill Gates as the measure of happiness, then no one is ever going to be happy, because no one can ever be that, right? Not everyone can be that, and you will not probably be like that. And that coming short of that means what, we're not successful? I hope that's not the case, right? I hope that's not the case of what we're measuring. We're, our bar is, you know, these people again that he listed. I know what he's trying to say is, you know, you don't have to do the traditional route or finish the traditional route. All those people were on that route at some point. But if that's a measure of success, yeah, that's hard. That's why I don't like the idea of practice makes perfect. No. Practice makes perfect is what people that like to be disappointed all the time say to themselves, right? Practice makes better. Education makes better. If we can move on with that, then we will be happier and we will be more successful, right? That's my thought. This did make some good ideas. I think the biggest thing we could take away from this, though, was as far as the positivity is, assess why you are doing the thing that you are wanting to do. You know, school, are you doing it just to complete it? Right? Focus, right? Have a plan. Know what your options are. Know what you want to do. Know what makes you happy. And if school takes you that path, you should do that. Right? If you have some other way, good luck. Good luck with that. That's what I got to say. All right, we'll see you guys next time. Bye.